Hello, today we'll be looking at how to make an 8-bit mat. Some may be wondering, why? One reason is to save space, the other is to be compatible with those who don't have a voodoo card, which is next to none. As some of you know, Jedi Knight was originally developed for computers that could only handle a maximum of 256 colors, but had 16-bit color mode as a bonus. However, this 8-bit color setup is rather complicated. It is a palette of 256 colors, each having 64 values for brightness, and 256 values for when you look through translucent surfaces, as well as during Capture the Flag games there are two extra color palettes that tint the sector red and gold, which had the computer cycling through a clutter of over 100,000 colors. But enough with the confusing technical specs, we're only here to look at the first 256 colors. Let's get down to the conversion, shall we? First off, you'll need to convert a color map. Go to your Jedi Knight resource folder, open the res2 gob, and extract from misc.cmp the color map you'd like to use. A good starting point is to use the default color map. Next, we are going to download JK Paint off of JK Hub. Links are in the description. Open JK Paint, click open, and look for your color map. Wherever that is. Here. Yeah, I have PaintShop Pro here, and I put all my palettes here, but let's go with default. Now click the Select Palette button, and click Save As, and we shall save it as a PaintShop Pro PAL Palettes PAL. Pal. And we'll save and give it a name. Yeah, appropriate name. Default.pal. Let's go with that, shall we? Now we need a program that can handle palettes well. What I have used for a long time has been Jask PaintShop Pro, which is now owned by Coral and costs a bit. Actually, wonder if the latest version still supports palettes. I've been using version 7. Anyways, we'll use something that is free and available to all, the GNU Image Manipulation Program.
That's a dog.
Yeah, well, whatever. So, open GIMP and load your texture. Let's take this one. That's lovely. Now, go to Windows, Dockable Dialogues, and open Palettes. Now click on this little arrow here, go to Palettes menu, and Import Palette. Click on Palette File, and search for your palette. Where did we put it? It was somewhere around the network. No, not patterns, palettes. Dilf Pal. Yay! Now you'll notice the pink area around here. This is normal for the default color map. As you may know, different levels have a different theme, and this is emphasized in the colors. There are 192 colors common to the whole game, and then there are 64 reserved colors for the different levels. For example, Nar Shaddaa has a bit of rust in its bluish metal, and Ceylon has some rust with blue skies and blue water. If you wish to have a mat compatible with it all, keep to the default. Otherwise, if your level is going to have a specific color theme, you can convert one of the others. Alright, import that. And there it is. Now, go to Image, Mode, Indexed. Select Use Custom Palette, and find our default PAL, or whatever you named it, if you named it anything else. Make sure that Remove Unused Colors is unchecked, and Dithering, well, it's to your liking if you want it dithered or not. You can say no, and yeah, the image will look something like this. Now if we just undo that and go again, Mode Indexed, and select another kind of dithering, we get dithering. That's what dithering is, means, that you get a random number of pixels to try to match the color. You may have seen it up close on some posters when waiting for a bus or something, I don't know. But, you know, just play around until you get what you... until you get the dithering that you are most comfortable with. Not sure about that, but well, let's go with that. Once satisfied with your result, it is time to save it. Be sure to save it as a bitmap file. So let's call it, switch 8-bit and save. No compression, no run length encoding, just save it as is. Alright, now you are to use Matmaster here, file new texture mat, and convert it straight off. Where did we put it? C-mat, I believe it was called, can't find it, WR, there it is. We take this, no need to remap palette because we've already done so, and click mat to save as mat, and there we go. WR switch 8-bit, something like that, good. And you're done. You'll probably notice that mats do not contain any palette information. Now for the bonus round! For those who make mods like weapons mods or special levels that need to be played as a mod, would probably like to have some nice snazzy menu backgrounds. Now, menu backgrounds must be 8-bit.
Why?
Because Lek didn't think it worth handling the Direct3D just for the sake of menus. For this, you'll need to import the UI color map palette. Let's see now, where did we put that? I mean, well, in the same place as all my other palettes. UI color map pal. There we go. Next, you'll need to find yourself some nice pictures, one or more. Let's go with this one. That's so wrong. You also need to make sure that it's 640 by 480. Again, Jedi Knight limitations. If it's any other size, resize it. There. And resize it before applying the palette. Now, if you're not too picky about the quality and the colors, you can just straight off go through mode index, you know, what we've gone through. This time picking UI color map, and there. However, a BM can hold a palette. So if you want to be a little more picky, here's what you have to do. Go into Image, Mode, Indexed, select Generate Optimum Palette, and type in the number 224. And convert. Did I like that? No, I don't think I like that. I'm gonna tell it to be a... There. Now in the palettes window, click the little arrow, palettes menu, import palette, and this time select the image. Now with our... let's call it... Yeah, so wrong. Import. And there it is. Now, find the UI color map. Click the little pen icon here to edit the palette. And then down here, we'll need to write down each of these last 32 colors. These last 32 colors are common for the text in the menus. The different menus may have different colors, but the last 32 must be the same all over for the text. If you want to utilize all 256 colors for your picture, then you'll also have to redo the SFT font to match all the background pictures. Now find the palette that you got from the image, click on the pen button to edit, and start filling in the colors. You do this by selecting the foreground color, and then typing in your numbers here, which was 212, okay, and then click on the little plus here, end page, new color from foreground color, click, there you go. Now repeat, 1 for 1, becomes 1 for 1, yes please, and add. 1, 3, yes please, and add. Now that we've set our colors, we're not done yet, because this hasn't actually been applied to the image. We need to go to Colors, Map, Set Color Map, and select the So Wrong. Okay. Once you've got that done, save it as a bitmap, and name it accordingly to what it's going to be used for. For example, BK main is for the first menu that pops up when you start the game. Alternatively, it's escape and search, and well, you get the idea. Just look at the list in the description for what it's supposed to be used for. Also, it needs to be saved in a special place. It needs to be saved in your project's, in your project's UI BM folder. So bkmain.bmp, not BM yet, no encoding, and save. Okay, now that you've saved that, open up JK Paint. Click on the new button up here. So make sure BM and 8-bit is selected. Go into the Select Palette, click Open, select your bitmap here, BK main, that we've called it. Make sure everything looks good, okay. Now click on the plus to add a frame, and in menus you can only have one frame. Sad to say, but that's the JK limits. Select your BK main bitmap, open, click on Properties, make sure you've got Yes on Internal Palette. The offset is only used for HUDs, so to offset various graphics and overlay graphics. Transparent color you don't need to fiddle with, that will take away that. The game takes care of the transparency for the menus automatically, so you don't need to bother with that yet. So click OK with that, go to File, Save As, and we save as bkmain.bitmap. Now, remember, we are not adding the P to this, it is only BM textures. And make sure it's in your project as well. Yeah, project UI BM. Yeah, fitting name. Save. And now that once you run the game, pointing the path to your project path, you should see this lovely image welcoming you to your new mod. Yeah, that is a very lovely image. Zero Raven is probably going to kill me for this. Let's close this immediately. Yeah. So, I hope you've learned something new here. Notice that in mods, the last 32 colors are different, so you'll have to take note of those as well. But anyways, hope you've learned something new from all of this. Enjoy your editing!